fear not. Eyes have they, but they see not. They have ears, but they hear not. Neither is there any breath in their mouth. They that make them are like unto them. So is everyone that trusteth in them. The principle is this. You become like the God you worship. They that make them are like unto them. Everyone that trusts in them, just like them. You become like the God you worship. You become like the God you trust in. That's exactly what's happening in Romans chapter 1. People get this view about God, and it comes down to something that looks like man, and so therefore they worship men. And worse still, they have God that's like an animal. And so it's no wonder that people behave like animals. Become like the God that you worship. Jesus said in Luke 6:36, be therefore merciful, as your Father in heaven is merciful. 2 Corinthians 3:18 says, but we all with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, were changed into the same image, from glory to glory, even as by the Spirit of the Lord. It's called transformation. And it is possible. Let's pray. Gracious God, again, we thank you for the way that you have revealed yourself to us in the Scriptures. Lord, all we need to know about you is here in the Scriptures. All we need for a life of godliness is here in the Scriptures. We can be merciful because, well, you have shown yourself to us as a merciful God. And as we allow our minds to be filled with such thoughts, it affects our thinking, affects our actions, affects our behaviour, affects our character. We become like the God we adoringly worship. To be holy even as our Father in heaven is holy. Everything we need for a life of godliness is here given to us in the Scriptures, where we learn the knowledge of God, the knowledge of the holy, the knowledge of the merciful, the knowledge of one who loves us. Help us to see these things. Help us to become more like you. I pray in Jesus' name.